Alright guys, so we're heading back home now. Our good buddy Jackson was concerned for us, and he called a social worker in. We're having a bit of issues, so we're gonna go back and wait on her. So I'll see you when we get there. Okay guys, well, she's here. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Hi there.
You're
Travis?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, my name's Amanda. I'm a social worker for the camp.
Nice to meet you, Amanda.
I had somebody called in that you might not have taken that fire very well. That explosion.
Here, go ahead and step out. Here, you can go ahead and step inside the lawn here. Excuse the mess. I'm remodeling at the moment, so you'll just have to forgive me. Get away from the road. People can't really drive. yeah, that was.
I've noticed.
That was probably Jackson, a good friend of mine. How do I start this? I mean, I guess you could say I've not been doing the best. I haven't been very good, but, you know.
Okay. The best I can do is refer you to a psychologist, if you like. They can give you a call within a couple of days.
Sure, I guess.
If it's an emergency, I can probably get you... the hospital would be the best thing I can do.
I don't need no hospital. I just, Jackson's just, I guess, concerned and all that. It was a really big call. Seeing everything from start to finish. Well, not from start to finish, but pretty much towards the last 5 minutes of it. A guy had rigged a car bomb, and they got into a car chase and stopped just on the bridge above the station over there in Grapeseed, and they exploded the bomb, and it nearly killed three officers, from what I understand. It luckily nobody got injured, but it flew right over their heads and straight in front of the fire station. Our CCTV cameras caught every bit of it. I've been struggling a little bit with that.
It's okay. Take a breath.
My job as a firefighter, and a paramedic, is to serve the public and help them when they are in need. And even though he was a very, I assume it was a he, even though that person in the van was a very, I don't want to say a bad person, but a very unstable person for making bombs and trying to kill people, I still just, it hurts me that I couldn't help him. And when we got there, I'm sorry.
it's not your fault.
I've been trying to tell myself that, but it just really was a bad scene. When we started to put out the fire, I hopped on our engine with Lieutenant Hash, and he went up there with the cops, and it turns out there was live ammunition inside the RV, and as we were trying to suppress the fire, the ammo was going off and shoot. It was just popping off, and it sounded like somebody was still shooting inside.
That would be terrifying.
It was. I've been with the Harmony Township Fire Department for I'm still relatively new, but I've been here a few weeks. Before I moved here and became full time, I did a little bit of volunteer work for a different county a little ways away. We got bad calls, but up here it's nothing. Well, it's nothing compared to up here. And I've been keeping all of these calls suppressed in me, just sort of bottled up. I don't like to discuss them with people. A lot of the times, because when I do, people don't understand. Because unless you're a firefighter or you're a paramedic, you don't really understand the horror we've seen. There was a before I moved here, I worked for the St. Lawrence County Fire Rescue, and we had a th there was a I'm sorry. There was a farm's a propane tank at a farm silo exploded. It was a big industrial storage area for all the farmers in the area, and the lady who was there was mentally unstable. And when the tank exploded, it blew her to the ground, and she had burns all over her body, and she had a major gash on her arm. And because she was mentally unstable, we couldn't do a lot of stuff for her. She I'm sorry. We tried to get to put an IV in her and to give her some pain medicine, and she tried, she fought us tooth and nail on it. We had to restrain her and give her ketamine, which is a sedation type medicine. It's just,
Yeah.
unless you're doing this, you don't really understand the pain and the horror of what really goes on.
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure talking about it will help. I can get your name to a professional who can give you that help if you're up for it.
Go ahead.
Okay. I can do that for you. Are you going to be okay now?
I should be a little better. I
Don't you
guess.
don't feel like you're gonna hurt yourself at all?
No. I couldn't do that even if I wanted to. I feel like
Not gonna hurt anybody else?
no, ma'am. I couldn't do that. I period.
Okay.
I just it,
I have to ask those questions.
I understand. It's part of your job. I should be okay to go back to work and all that. I don't know. Maybe it is time that I see a therapist instead of keeping this all bottled up.
It might be a good idea. Stave off some serious issues down the road.
Yeah. But yeah.
All right, well, I'll give your name to a therapist that I know, and I'll get them to okay.
All right. Well, thank you for the help.
No problem. Anything for our first response.
Yep.
You have a good day, okay?
You too. Be safe.
You as well. Bye now.
Right, bye. Yeah, so that being said, that is the end of this episode of SAFR.